Hi everyone, my name is Melissa Colon and I'm the Distance Education Coordinator at Columbia College. I'm here to help you download a third-party program called Blackboard Instant Messenger. It is a chat tool where you have to be synchronously connected to your fellow classmates or your instructor. So right now you see this on the menu. Most of the time you will be directed by your instructor as to when this is going to be available and how to use it. I'm just providing another way to demonstrate to you how the tool can be downloaded to your desktop and then you can participate with your instructor or your fellow classmates. So again, your instructor will provide a link. You will be able to click on that link. And a screen will pop up. I'm just going to move this down a little bit so you can see it. And you should have your information provided in this screen. Everyone will have their own information provided. Now notice you can change the password if you wanted to. One of the things that you will be able to do is change it right here. What you might want to do is just keep it the way it is so you can remember it and it's not another password. And then you will be logging in to the Blackboard IM. Once you install it, you will be logging into it outside of Blackboard. Now, you can download this program as many times as you like and on as many computers as you like. And here's how we get started. This right here is going to be what computer operating system you have. So you will download the Windows 7 Vista XP if you are working on a PC. If you are a Mac person, you're going to be downloading the Mac OS X version. So because I am on a PC, I'm going to be downloading the Windows 7 Vista XP version. Okay, here we go. I'm going to start downloading the program. Now when I click on it, notice at the very bottom left, you're going to see this little bar and you're going to see the file that has just downloaded it. It may take a few seconds. All right, so now you see this at the very bottom, and now I'm going to start to install the program. A reminder, if you want to know where the program has downloaded to, you can click on this link and a dialog box will open up, and notice that this is in my downloads. And you can actually go to your downloads folder and you could actually install it from there. To install it right here on the left hand side where it's actually listed, I can just click and a dialog box will pop up and it gives you some information. And you can click on the Run button and you should see another dialog box pop up, installer language, English, and then it's going to take you through a series of steps. You can read through that if you like, and of course you're going to have to agree to the Collaborative Instant Messaging Service Agreement. I agree. And then, yes, I would recommend that you provide yourself a desktop shortcut and a quick launch shortcut. If you're not sure about that, you can uncheck it and you can actually set up a shortcut later. I like the desktop shortcut because it always stays on my desktop, and you'll see in just a few minutes what that looks like. I'm going to click on the next button. And then I am going to just allow it to go to the default destination folder. I usually do that because usually programs, when you install them, they choose the correct folder. All right. And I can click finish to close the wizard, or I can run the Blackboard IM. And I do want to run it, so I'm going to click on finish and then run it. Okay, so again, I've finished. And now what has popped up is the Blackboard Collaborate Instant Messenger, where I can log in. Log in with your username and log in with your password. You could put remember me if you wanted or sign in automatically, but you have to remember you don't want to do this on a public computer. I think it's safer if you do it at home that way, but I usually don't do it at home or on a public computer. I always want to make sure I have the ability to sign in. So that's up to you. Once I have my username and password, remember you got that up here when you first clicked on the link inside your Blackboard classroom. Normally, it will be the same as your username and password when you first signed into Blackboard. So I've signed in. I'm going to click on Sign In, and notice it's connecting. And what happens here is this is a list of everyone who has a Blackboard IM active profile. So that means that all of these people in my list are instructors. So I'm going to see if I can get a hold of one. Now, these are all grayed out, so that means that they're not available. Normally, you're going to see a green circle if they're available. And people that have used this, especially your instructors, they know when to make this available, and they might even have an away message or a customized message. Most of your instructors will use this for office hours, or maybe they'll just have an open time where you can ask some questions. So let's try to get a hold of Sylvia Watterson. Going to select her name, click on it, so it opens up this dialog box. Now this is just a simple chat room, and I'm going to say, "Hi Sylvia, we are just practicing." It's always good to practice. And then once I have typed that into the text box, I can click on enter on my keyboard, and then that has provided a message. Now if Sylvia was on, she would be able to chat back with me. And then it looks like she's offline, so it kind of gives you the status of those that have activated their profiles. Now I can also call someone, so no one is really able to be called right now because no one is online, but I could actually call and we could talk using our voice over IP. So that means if you have an internal microphone or an external microphone, you could hear somebody, their audio. We do not currently have the whiteboard feature that is for the premium, and we have what's called a light version of Blackboard IM. But the chat room is live and it's considered synchronous. That means you need to be on at the same time. And I do want to emphasize that your instructor will most likely have times that they are using this particular tool. The neat thing about it is you can also arrange to talk with your fellow classmates. You can make arrangements on your own to be in this Blackboard Instant Messenger at the same time, and then you can chat. So it doesn't necessarily need to be with an instructor. When you are finished with contacting your fellow classmates or being online with your instructor, you can log out by going to Blackboard IM Sign Out, and then you should see your name here. So explore some of the features within the Blackboard Collaborate. And again, this can be downloaded to any computer that you use, whether it's at home or at school. You will always be signing in for the most part, and this will be a tool that you can use to collaborate and also chat live with your fellow classmates and your instructor. Well, that's about it for now. I hope that has helped, and I appreciate your attention. Give us a call in the ITC at 588-5011 if you'd like us to walk you through the process. Thank you.